Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihara. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jaya Radha Gopinath, Radha Gopinath, Radhe. Jaya Gauranitha, 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 Jaya Gauranitha. Jaya Shri Gopal, Shri Gopal, Shri Gopal, Jaya Shri Gopal. Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jai Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेष्व भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती रुत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th canto, chapter 30, entitled The Disappearance of the Yadu Dynasty. Text number 7 to 12, because 7 doesn't have purport. Tatra bhishiccha shuchaya उपोष्य सुसमाहिताः देवताः पूजयिष्यामः स्नपनालेपनार्हणैः तत्राभिषिच्य शुचय उपोष्य सुसमाहिताः देवताः पूजयिष्यामः स्नपनालेपनार्हणैः तत्राभिषिच्य शुचय उपोष्य सुसमाहिताः देवताः पूजयिष्यामः स्नपनालेपनार्हणैः। तत्राभिषिच्य शुचय च सुजनाः देवताः पूजयिष्यामः स्नपनालेपनार्हणैः तत्राभिषिच्य शुचय उपोष्य सुसमाहिताः देवताः पूजयिष्यामः स्नपनालेपनाः तत्राभिषिच्य शुचय उपोष्य सुसमाहिता देवता पूजयिष्यामः स्नपनालेपनार्हणैः। तत्र देर अभिषिच्य टेकिंग बाथ शुचयः क्लेन्स्ड उपोष्य फास्टिंग सुसमाहिताः फिक्स्ड फिक्सिंग आवर माइंड्स देवताः द डेमिगॉड्स पूजयिष्यामः वी शैल वर्शिप स्नपन बाय बेदिंग आलेपन Smearing with sandalwood, arhanaihi, and by various offerings. Translation: There we should bathe for purification, fast, and fix our minds in meditation. We should then worship the demigods by bathing their images, anointing them with sandalwood pulp and presenting them various offerings. Text 8. After performing the expiatory rituals with the help of greatly fortunate brahmanas, we will worship those brahmanas by offering them cows, land, gold, clothing, elephants, horses, chariots, dwelling places. Text 9. This is indeed the appropriate process for counteracting our imminent adversity, and it is sure to bring about the highest good fortune. Such worship of the demigods, brahmanas, and cows can earn the highest birth for all living entities. Having heard these words from Lord Krishna, the enemy of Madhu, the elders of the Yadu dynasty gave their assent, saying, "So be it." After crossing over the ocean in boats, they proceeded on chariots to Prabhasa. Text 11. There, with great devotion, the Yadavas performed the religious ceremonies according to the instructions of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, their personal Lord. They also performed various other auspicious rituals. Then their intelligence covered by providence, tatas tasmin mahapanam papur maireyakam madhu dishta vibhramshitadhyo yadravair bhrashyate matihi. Then their intelligence covered by providence, they literally indulged in drinking the sweet maireya beverage, which can completely intoxicate the mind. Purport by Srila Prabhupada's disciples. The word dishta here indicates the desire of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In the first chapter of this canto, The Curse Upon the Yadu Dynasty, this incident is elaborately explained.
Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuronmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Bano Bhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamahyam Dadati Sapadantikam Vandeham Sri Guruhu Sri Yuta Padakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakhanvitamscha. He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Nam. Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare.
Hare Krishna. So, this particular section is telling how Lord Krishna turned the apparent inauspicious adversity into another opportunity. Like we were also discussing last time. That's Krishna consciousness. To turn adversities into opportunities. The adversity of lockdown provided an opportunity to learn harmonium. My Shiksha Guru in this, for this instrument learning is His Grace Guru Gaurang Prabhu. He may not know, but I just kind of see him. No guru, self-made guru. But not like Ekalavya. Like Arjun. Really wanting to serve. And the diligence with which he practices and the great respect with which he deals with his so many flutes he has, a big box, and every time he keeps polishing it, seeing it as like part of Balaramji. So sometimes without your knowledge you may be inspiring practically the whole community or people all over the world. Provided you are watering the root of the tree, then every part of the tree is nourished. So without our knowledge, sometimes we wonder, I'm not able to preach, I'm not able to teach. But then sometimes without, most of the times, without saying a word, you speak a lot. You are sending a clear-cut message for the intelligent people to understand, capture, imbibe. So I always think, His Grace Jananivas Prabhu, Pankajangri Prabhu, hardly I have ever seen them giving regular classes. They don't travel much. But just there, that particular service for the pleasure of Guru and Radha Madhav, they are performing. Just by thinking about that service, just by remembering that service, and by visiting and just looking at them, we are inspired to perform our devotion with such commitment, sincerity, and dedication. I don't know how many gopis will be attracted to Guru Gaurang Prabhu's flute, but I'm sure Krishna will be attracted because he really does it in the mood of servant of the servant, trying to assist different singers, trying to create a very sweet environment for the message to be heard and nice. So, Krishna has, of course, he himself has created this apparently inauspicious omens. In the last few days, we have had theses being presented in each class. Starting with Baldev Prabhu, I think last Sunday, presenting the connection between the first chapter, the third chapter, and you know, in the 11th, I mean, first canto, third canto, 11th canto. It's all actually a continuity in the story. You had Gaurvilas Prabhu presenting, you know, complete thesis on different reasons of Krishna's disappearance along with the Yadus. And then we had one thesis by Kesho Chandra on omens. Actually, each of the verses on one particular word, sometimes that becomes like the core of that particular verse. Like for example, here it is Dishta in this particular verse. Based on that you can, it's like a password that opens a file, huge, unlimited file of information in relation and connection with that. So, today, I was thinking that this particular Dishta, Dishta has been translated by Srila Prabhupada as it's the last verse. Sorry. Destiny. That's the word that's been. Of course, this particular, eventually, whether it is, what is called Dishta, Daiva, Providence, ultimately is the will of the Lord. It's very difficult to understand the will of the Lord. Even Bhishma says, no one can ever understand the will of the Lord. It can come in the form of Kala. Kala reveals the plan of the Lord. Until Kala reveals, practically no one can ever understand the full import of the will of the Lord. And so, what to speak of the Lord? Vaishnavera Kriyamudra Vigyana Bujhai. Even the activities of a very, very grave, deep and exalted devotee of the Lord, whose only desire is to make his desire one with the Lord's desire. Even his action is actually difficult to comprehend. But in this particular connection, it's about removing the burden. Initially the burden of the earth, and now the burden of the Yadavas. And in the previous classes, we have already discussed several reasons why Krishna wanted to take back the Yadavas before he departed, making sure that everything is wound up nicely, not haphazardly. So, this thing of removing the burden. Kunti, in her prayers in the first canto, while giving various reasons what various people have told about the purpose of Lord's appearance, expresses one of the purposes. Bharavataranaya anye bhuvo nava ivo dadhau Siddhantya Bhuri Bharena Jatohi Atma Bhuvarthita Jataha. One of the reasons, Ajata, that the Lord is Ajata, he doesn't take birth, but then he has taken birth. Jataha Atma Bhuvarthita. When Brahmaji prayed, Atma Bhuvarthita. Why did Brahmaji pray for the Lord to descend? Because the issue that was brought to him, he couldn't handle. Bhara avataranaya anye. Some people say one of the reasons why the Lord descended, Bhara avataranaya, whose? Bhuvo nava ivo udadhau. Like a ship overburdened by the goods in the middle of the ocean, there is a danger of it sinking. Similarly, Siddhantyaha Bhuri Bharena Bhuva. The earth, Siddhantya, it was distressed, suffering. Siddhantyaha Bhuri Bharena. Too much of weight, overburdened. And therefore, Lord Brahma prayed. Invariably, the Lord never descends till the devotees pray. In all the avatars, in the Dashavatara Stotra, we see everything. There is a calamity, there is some big mess that has been created, people are not able to resolve it, or the power is so much that they are helpless. And that is the time the Lord comes to to actually remove that burden. And the state government is not able to handle, they refer it to the center. You send the help, whether it is the police force, whether it is money, whether it is whatever, resources, and they come and they do the needful. After that, that resource becomes burdensome. Then you have to send back. Okay, purpose is served, thank you. In Jagannath Puri, during this Rath Yatra, I don't know, this will ever happen this year, but they can't handle, the local police can't handle the crowd, because they are all their neighbors only who have come to the Jagannath Rath Yatra. So they can't handle them. They have to live there along with them only. And a local man, hey, kon kocha, basa. He may chastise them in the local language. So therefore they call CRPF, Central Reserve Police Force. Only they can handle this crowd, otherwise very difficult. And after that they do nice tambula and over. Gundicha is over now. You know, not even till 9 days. Actually after the second day, over. And so for Brahmaji has told, Prabhu, if you so desire, you can't tell them to go. If you so desire, like Lord Advaita said, Baula ke kohi ho loka hoila baula, Baula ke kohi ho hate nabikaye chaula, Baula ke kohi ho iha koriya che aula, Baula ke kohi ho iha kohiya che baula. Baula, baula means mad. Tell the madman, Baula ke kohi ho loka hoila baula. He sent a very anonymous, enigmatic verse. Advaita Acharya come. Advaita Acharya had called, Lord Chaitanya told Advaita, you called me and therefore I have come. So it was the responsibility of Advaita, the purpose for which he was called, after it is done, at least to indicate, Prabhu, note it down, everything is clear, sanctioned. Thank you very much. So Baula ke kohi ho, loka hoila Baula, everyone has become mad. Perfect. Evam vradasva priyanama kirtya jata anurago drita chitta uchchaihi hasati roditi rauti ga unmadavat nrityati loka bahya. Everyone is dancing in madness, oblivious to the surroundings. So that medicine for which you came to give, that has worked and everyone has become normal. Corona chala gaya. Now you can, all the hospitals were closed down, China also. Temporary hospitals, everything was closed down once the thing was over. So similarly, the Lord specifically came to remove the, he invariably comes every time to actually remove the burden of this world. Now, this understanding of this word burden, bhara, it's a very relative concept in one sense. Anything can become a burden at any time, in different ways. Sometimes, after the use of that object, it becomes a burden. Till that use is there, it's very useful. Then it becomes a burden. For example, before the rains, we bring all these huge bamboos and the sheets to be put on top and cover. You know, it's a huge lot of stuff being brought, kept there and put up there. But after the 4 months, immediately we want to get rid of it. Ho gaya, kaam ho gaya uska. Food is good. Yuktahara, but atyahara The same food which is actually nourishing to the body, if taken beyond a particular level, the same food can become toxic to the body, or at least burdensome to the body. Medicine, just because it is tasty, you can't take 6 months quota together. That becomes toxic. That becomes burdensome. Poisonous to the whole body, and acting against the body itself. After a particular time, you call somebody as a guest. You're so happy that person has come. But if that person overstays, of course, as a cultured person, one may not. But then, you should realize, oh, it's become a burden. The body has a specific purpose. After the purpose is served, it becomes a burden. So, this actually Mother Earth is not burdened by any of its huge structures, huge mountains, huge forests, you know, billions and tons and gallons of water in the ocean. That's not a burden for Mother Earth. Just like for the parents, children are not a burden. But if they act against the interest of the family, then they become burdensome. Citizens are not a burden. But if the citizens start acting against the interest of the nation, conspiring or acting against, they become burden. Antisocial elements become burden. It's a big burden actually. I was just thinking, just when the first time I took my brother to the airport when I was young, first time my brother got promotion, he was go to Calcutta from Bangalore, a flight. I remember we walked till the airport and saw him off inside. Seat mein bata ke bag deke then we. You know, it was like bus or train. You go inside and you know, seat rakke, okay, saman upar rakh diya, sab theek hai, aap baitho baitho. Especially little old person. The younger person comes and you know, his mother, parents are there, all the luggage is kept and then sits there for some time. And as soon as the signal is down, okay, theek hai, theek thaak hai, phone karte rehna. This was the situation. But now, how much revenue on just security? So much, including in the temple. They had to have security just to check everyone. All over, in every society, in every this, so much. So much of revenue, so much of burden. Unnecessary necessities. Prabhupada calls it in the seventh canto. So, Mother Earth, she's very happy. Tasam Brahma Mahadyonir Aham Bija Pradah Pita. She's very happy to produce such kind of progeny who understand the interest of the father and will and take upon themselves the burden rather than being the burden. So that is the Sura and the Asura. Suras are those who act to release the burden. And Asura are those who become the burden. So this whole understanding in Vedic culture is truly to lighten the burden. That's the responsibility, at least in the human form of life. Dharmo hitesham adhiko vishesh. Dharmena hina pashu visam. In fact, actually, pashus are not burden. They will take as much as necessary. This pashu, dvipada pashu, is the root cause of all burden on this planet. He can relieve the burden or he can be the burden. So, when does that, like one devotee was very nicely explaining, and it actually immediately connected to me, my heart. He said, the devata means, deva means those who give more and take less from the society. And so they are considered assets. And then there are those who take more and give less. And they become liability. Imagine you employ a servant, takes 500 rupees salary and 5000 rupees salary, does only 500 rupees work. You may not be inspired to keep that person. So this is in a very, very kind of mundane level. So the human being, in the beginning he is a burden, in the end he is a burden. In between is the middle time where he contributes. But because human civilization is a very civilized society, it understands, it acknowledges that for us to survive even a breath in this world, how much we have received from the mother's womb when she is so sensitive in terms of what she eats, just to see that the child inside is properly nourished and fed. Till, you know, then is one, only human being is generally helpless in childhood. The other animals are not as helpless. Immediately they become active. They're forced to become active. Human being is like that. One devotee was expressing, hardly we see any crow dying unless they get electrocuted somewhere. You wonder where they go. Somewhere they go and... You know, I think time aa gaya kahin to jaane ka bhi. Vanaprastha in sannyas. Because somewhere they just disappear. Hardly you ever see. So the birds, the animals, unless they meet an accident or something. So, therefore, the culture of acknowledging what we have received and giving back. So this Panchamahayagya, we have received and therefore we need to give back. Eventually a point where you accept the least and give the most. That is person like Sukadeva Goswami, a sannyasi. Karatala bhiksha tarutala vas. Just whatever comes in the hand, that's for the day. And tarutala vas, not even same taru after. Different taru. Absolutely, like what that madhukari. Not trying to become a burden on anyone. Well, that's the ideal. We can't even imagine. It's very nice to speak this. But this whole idea is this. That it's how much relieving the burden than being the burden. There was a person who sent me a message, said, jo apne liye jeeta hai, uska maran hota hai. जो अपने लिए जीता है उसका मरण होता है, जो औरों के लिए जीता है उसका स्मरण होता है. सो So that's the kind of life that the principle of yajna. Yajna is that. From selfishness to selflessness. In the whole of Ramayana, I said somebody sent me that whole Ramayana thing and I'm watching after 30, 35 years. It reminded me that old Ramayana, Ramananda Sagar. I'm seeing, and it is so, when they show Ravan, very, very nicely designed. So as Ravan walks in, everyone is dancing and receiving him and glorifying him. All his exploits are composed into a nice song. And the ladies are coming and dancing as he walks into the... It's nice, no? To hear all the things that you have done. And Prithu Maharaj heard this, he said, hey, keep quiet. Pehle karne do mereko. Bolo mat. You know, all these Mughal emperors used to have their glories written down and composed, and they would hear this. Whereas Kulashekhar would hear the Lord's glories. This is the difference between the culture. And then you always see two people fanning, two young beautiful ladies fanning the chamara to this fellow. And he's sitting like, you know, staircase. So much, practically a staircase sitting up there. Literally, you have to look up to, forced to look up to him. You demand respect than commanding respect. So, and then you have in Ayodhya, one lady was enough to divide everyone. One lady. And it took the whole family to unite. And it was only all the damage could be controlled because so many people sacrificed so that the damage could be the least and nothing could. Bharat, he stopped it right there. He could have said, okay, this is the dishta, will of the Lord. It has come on its own. He said, nothing doing. And Ram and Sita, Sita and Lakshman, they were not. So you see that this whole spirit of the Ramayana between the Daiva and the Danava, or the Deva and Danava, or the Sura and Asuras, is about that. Srila Prabhupada was asked by, I think, Pushta Krishna Prabhu. Bhartiya Vidya Bhavan had sent about 10 questions to all the spiritual organizations. And that was asked to him and he replied, and that became a small book, Transcendence and Civilization, Civilization and Transcendence. In that, one of the questions is, because of this destiny, everything, Indians have become very lazy. Sab upar wale ke haath mein hai, uski ichha ke anusar. Because of dishta, people have become lazy. And over-dependence on the Lord. So Prabhupada answered it so nicely. So what is civilization? Civilization doesn't mean running on four wheels. The animals are running on four legs, they are running on four wheels. No. Civilization means simple living and high thinking. That's civilization. And he said, if they were lazy, the point was, this philosophy has made the people very lazy. So he said, if they were lazy, if you go to Kumbh Mela, people come from all over. They walk. There is practically no facilities. Anyone who is health conscious will never go. So much. The water, too much crowd. Extremely cold. So much austerity. And for what? just to take one dip, and that's extremely cold. He said, if they were lazy, would they do that? Would they take the trouble? Would they take all the austerity to be there, to stay there, to travel? Health risk, risk of health. Risk of loss. Bhule bisre tambu, you know, all that. Ye chala gaya, uske koi ho gaya hai, ye gaon ka ladka. Uske maa baap yahan hai to le aaye. 6 saal ka bablu, mata ka naam ye, pita ka naam ye. There are so many tents declaring. Losing your case, you know. So, why would they do it? Civilization means spiritual progress is the focus. And everything else, actually, through this process of yajna, as described in the 3rd chapter of Bhagavad Gita, anena prasavishyadvam eshavos twishta kamadhuk, materially prosperity and spiritually progressive. Why India was sone ki chidiya? Desh ki dharti sona ugle. It's a fact. If this is the consciousness of every people, you cannot but have prosperity. If everyone is this yajna conscious, yajnarthat karmanah, anyatra lokoyam karma bandhan. Otherwise it will be burden. Everyone will be burden to everyone. Everyone will be complaining rather than contributing. So, annad bhavanti bhutani, parjanyad anna sambhavah, yajyad bhavati parjanyo, yajyah karma samudbhavah. Annad bhavanti bhutani. If you have to live, you have to eat. Annad bhavanti. Without that, one can't survive. Ahara nidra bhai maitha. It's necessary. So, annad bhavanti parjanyad anna sambhavah. Rain is a must. However technologically advanced, no water, the whole city has to leave. Yajna bhavati parjanyo. What is that yajna? Today the whole weather uncertainties is only because of exploitative mentality, individually, collectively. That's the only reason. One environmentalist told, of all these species, if only one species go away, no loss to this planet. That is the human species. And all the problems are only because of the human species. It is a fact. So that the Vedic culture recognized. Yajnat bhavati parjan. And what is this yajna? Yajna karma samudbhava. अच्छा, what karma? Karma brahmodbhavam. Brahma means scriptures. Varnashram. According to your varna, according to your ashram, you have specific obligations, responsibilities and duties. Karmani, yajnat bhavati parjanyo, yajna karma. Karma brahmodbhavam vidhi. And Brahma, where did scriptures come from? Akshara samudbhavam. From the Lord, Akshara. Tasmat sarvagatam brahma nityam yajna pratishthitam. So whether it is the lowest form of selflessness in the form of me and my family, even that is good. Even that is good. Me and the nation, me and, the whole planet. Vasudhaiva kutumbakam. That is too big a deal. That's a high level rishi. But Rishi Tattva means trying to give back. From immediate, recognizing the immediate source, at least. You know, I like very beautiful verse that came in the last chapter, conclusion of the last chapters. How Krishna, like a bee, took the essence of the Vedic literature without crushing the other inferior temporary steps. A bee takes the honey from the flower without crushing the flower. Similarly, Krishna emphasized the bhakti yoga without minimizing, because there will be different shlokas for different folks. There will be different levels of consciousness, from most mundane to the most spiritual. It will be. And therefore, there are, all of it has to be respected. Just because you are in PhD, you can't say all these KG schools should be closed. But there will always be people who will enter that from there and then gradually come up. That's a part of education. So we respect all of that, even though one may have come by grace or by hard work, come up to the top. But the fact is, all of that is necessary. So, evam pravartitam chakram na anuvartayati hayah aghayuhu indriya ramah mogham. He becomes a burden. His life is worthless. His life, Mother Earth, even if he is only 45 kilos, she feels burdensome. But somebody may be 120 kilos, but he may be relieving her burden. Aghayuhu indriya rama. Agha ayuhu. Agha means sinful and selfish. Indriya rama. What's in it for me? Mogham partha sajivati. So the whole journey is from that. Being a burden to relieving the burden. So, as one person said, in movement there is stability. And when there is stability, you see the movement happening there. Chakram, evam pravartitam chakram. You see a wheel. A wheel, if it is standing, it will fall. But when the wheel is moving, it is stable. You know, as kids, we used to have the tire, cycle tire, or sometimes only the rim without the spokes. You hold one stick into that groove of that rim and run full speed. In village, this is the entertainment. And whoever has the rim is a very opulent. Otherwise, phata phata tire repaired and tied with some cloth because the tire is also broke. If you have a rim, that means a very prestigious family is coming where they can throw the rim. So in that chakra, unless there is movement, there is no stability. So these different generations are like the spokes of that wheel. So one spoke is touching the ground right now. The previous one has gone behind and the next one is coming. This is the movement. Imagine if nobody retires, how will the next generation get the employment? Somebody has to retire. And before retirement, keeping that legacy in mind, the responsibility, the burden of training, so that the wheel moves on. It's like a relay race. This is that relay race. All these photographs that we have kept of all the acharyas, it's that race. They are running that race. They are holding the baton for some time. They are facing the challenges at that particular time. And then they hand over to the next and say, Seva se nivritt hua. Pehle pravritt hua, tab jaake nivritt hua. Talking too much about renunciation even before entering life, that sometimes, unfortunately, it happens. It's good to read about, you know, Parikshit Maharaj's renunciation. But imagine, even before getting into the vehicle, he's talking about retiring or getting down from the vehicle. First you run the vehicle, Baba, for some time. At the heart, one should have the Bhagavad philosophy. Antare nishtha karo bahye loko vyavahar Achirat Krishna Tomai Koribe Uddhar. So the Bhagavad philosophy is to be cultivated within the core of one's heart. Even though I may be on top of everything, everything is going on fine. But beware. You're just an instrument. Right in front of you, everything may collapse. Krishna is showing that lesson also. You have to be renounced in that particular way. From within, but externally executing the responsibilities. Mam anusmara yudhyacha. Mai arpita mano buddhir mamai vaishyasya samshaya. So, this chakra has come and now the baton is passed on to us. We have to run. We can't say, I am mood nahi hai mera. Hey, you can't do that. Already the baton is in your hands. Now, till you hand over to that next person. So, in the very interesting, Naimishe Anivisha Kshetre Rishayaha Saunakadayaha Satram Swargaya Lokaya Sahasra Samamasa. One person asked me, Prabhuji, how come they are performing for 1,000 years? Was life so long? I said, yeah, Dwapar Yuga. Even if you say in Dwapar Yuga, at the end of Dwapar Yuga, it was, say, 1,000 years. Still, he has to be born, he has to learn, and then he has to. How come 1,000 years? So one devotee was explaining, Satra means there is no one Yajman. Satra is a Yajna, just like Harinam Sankirtan Yajna, 7 days Akhand Harinam. It's not that one person only does, but after every 2 hours you take turns, or after every 4 hours you take turns. But the Yajna goes on. It's like running a country. President is chosen, Prime Minister is chosen, every 5 years. Fellow may come and go, but the yajna goes on. So, so the motivation to actually execute at the right time, with the right attitude, in a right way, and at the right time, it's all about timing also. At the right time, even to exit from the show. Dhritarashtra had to be told, Vidura, your time is up. Brahmarpanam, Brahmahavir, Brahmagno, Brahmana Hutam, Brahmahiva. So in 3rd chapter 9 to 16 and 4th chapter 24 to 34. These concepts are given. Before Sarodharman Parityajya, before the Bhagavatam, this is the foundation. And Prabhupada writes in that purport very beautifully, what is matter and what is spirit? Actually everything is spiritual. Andantarastha Paramanu Chayantarastham, like Prahlad Maharaj said, where there is not Krishna, Yomam Pashyati Sarvatra. Spirit covered by ignorance, Brahman covered by ignorance or sense gratification is matter. And matter dovetailed in the service of the spirit becomes spiritualized. That is why a sannyasi's body is not put on the fire, but actually, because it is completely spiritual, engaged in the service of the Lord. Manasa vacha karmana. So the spirit of yajna is this, basically this. We have come from the bodily consciousness and we have to move to Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma, spiritual consciousness of the soul, of the body, of the surroundings, of the things, of the situations. This is the journey. And the journey is complete. Even if somebody should at least begin the journey, from being a burden, that's the demoniac tendency. Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakashipu. Both the names are so significant. Hiranyaksha, his eyes was only where it is gold, or Hiranyakashipu, advanced, updated version. After Hiranya, then Kashipu, to enjoy that. And because of that, the earth went underneath Garbhodakosha, overburdened, overexploited. Sidantyaha Bhuri Bharen. And Varahadev lifted that earth and put it in the air by his potency. And the words used for Varahadev is Yajna Murti, Yajna Bhavana, Yajna Maya. His every hair on the body represented one particular Vajpayee Yajna, Ashwamedh Yajna, whatever. His Yajna Purusha. So he again lifted it back to its original position of what its purpose is. So, na ayam lokosti ayagyasya kutonya kurusattam. In fourth chapter, before that tadvidhi verse, if you want to understand, you have to approach a guru and submissively hear, otherwise you can't understand. He says, na ayam loko asti ayagyasya kuto anya. In this world, he can't be happy and he can't make others happy. What to speak of other worlds for him? Adhogati. So, ignorance leads to sinful life, and sinful life leads to continued material existence, which is burden. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. Increasing the pages of history book, Prabhupada writes. Each jiva continues to increase the pages of his history book in the 84 lakh species, rather than getting out from here. So, how do we relieve the burden? Lord Chaitanya specifically came to show the process of deliverance of self and of others for this age. Yajna Sankirtana Praye Yajantihi Sumedhasa. The most intelligent person. Who is the most intelligent person? Who realizes he has no intelligence. In Kali Yuga, Murkhami Nahi Amai, Mahaprabhu represented. Guru More Murkha Dekhi Karila Shasa. Hey, you rascal, you don't have right for Vedanta. You just chant the holy name. Not that he didn't know. He showed Prakashananda, he showed Sarvabhaumacharya. But he is demonstrating us. So, Neej Jati, Neej Sangni, Patita Adham, even Sanatana Goswami. So, Krishna Utkirtana Gana Nartana Parau Premamratambho Nidhi Dhira Adhira Janapriyau Priyakarau Nirmat Sarau Pujitau. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's followers, the GBC, original GBC of Lord Chaitanya, Samsthapaka, Saddharma Samsthapaka, they were the Samsthapaka Acharyas, Sri Chaitanya, Mano Abhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale. So what was their activity of relieving the burden? Bhara Avahantarakau. Bhara Avahantarakau. They did the greatest welfare to humanity by their example, by their words, and by their writings, and by their actions. They showed how to relieve the burden. Krishna Utkirtana Gana Nartana Parau. Parau means they were completely absorbed. One has to be absorbed. either absorbed in matter or absorbed in spirit. There is no in between. So, Gana Nartana Parau, Prema Amrita Abdhi, they were like ocean. Bhakti Rasa Amrita Sindhu. They were experiencing this Rasa, Bhakti Rasa. Dhira Adhira Jana Priyau, Priyakarau. Why? How were they, as Prabhupada says, they were dear to the gentle and the ruffians. Dhira Adhira Jana Priyau, Priyakarau. Why? Nirmatsarau Pujitau. Ultimately, that's the stage. Till we have that matsara, we will be subtly or grossly be a burden. That's the root cause for coming here and increasing the burden. As Krishna says, you can understand Arjun because you're not envious of me. Root causes the envy, because of which the mind, the senses, and then eventually the objects around we use for our own exploitation. And the whole system is created just for that purpose. We can see sometimes major wars are the leader's ego. Major wars in the world, country's ego. That's why it is said, Bhumi Drupta Nripa Vyaja. Right? 10th canto, beginning verse. Bhumi Drupta Nripa Vyaja. Shatayutai, Anikai Shatayutai. Expansion of military power to be the superpower. And we are seeing it even today. To any extent they are ready to go. Just so that the ego of the nation, the ego of the community, ego of an individual, ego of a society. Sometimes religion is also used simply as an instrument for one's ego. My way is the only way, everyone the highway. It's there. Some say it, some may not say it, but actions prove. So that's the root cause. So, dhira adhira jana priyau priyakarau nirmatsarau pujitau. That for them is the Bhagavat. For a sadhaka, bhakti is the process to earn the love. But for siddhas, bhakti is a process to exhibit that love. It's a natural. For us, Bhagavatam is Nityam Bhagavata Seva, just to purify. There, the Bhagavatam is just to relish. Kallola Magnao Mahur. Gopi Bhava Rasa Amrita Abdhila Hari Kallola Magnao Mahur. So, Sri Chaitanya Kripa Bharau, they carried the mercy of Lord Chaitanya on their shoulders. They took that responsibility. They took the burden. Sri Chaitanya Kripa Bharau, Bhuvi Bhuvo Bharava Hantarakau, to remove the burden. They took the burden upon themselves to remove the burden of the earth, which is assisting the Lord for which He comes. Therefore, those devotees who, there are two options. Either you are being the burden or you are relieving the burden. So when a person becomes an instrument of the Lord's desire for this world to relieve the burden, that person can never be a burden. As one devotee said, The test is, when you die, how many cry? I like that. This is the litmus test, whether you are a burden. Like Chaitanya Leela Prabhu told the other day, unka SOP, the demigod's SOP, whenever the demons are killed, now I used to read Mahabharat for the Gurukul children, and whenever I would say, ye asur ko mara, aur haan, din ka, daily kaam shuru ho gaya devtaon ka. The demigods come and shower flowers, apsaras come and dance, gandharvas come and sing, sages come and start praying. Thank you, my Lord. Dhenuka asur. Really ass. Burden of the beast, as they say. Gadha kahin ka. Really an ass, because he was in the form of an ass also. And very interesting. He didn't eat the fruit and he didn't allow to others to eat the fruit. This is the Dhenukasura mentality. Jadavidya jata mayara vaibhav tomar bhajane badha moha janamiya anitya samsare jivake banaye gadha. So, Bharavahan Tarakav, these personalities came and Devaki Nandan, one great Vaishnava, you know, Vrindavana Vasiyata Vaishnavarajan, he says that Brahmanda Tarite Shakti Dhare Jane Jane Evede Purane Guna Gaye Jeva Sune. He says, Brahmanda Tarite Shakti Dhare Jane Jane. Each one of Lord Chaitanya's devotees had the capacity to relieve a whole universe. Brahmanda Tarite Shakti. One Vasudev Dat was enough to relieve unconditionally, taking upon himself the burden of the sinful reactions to suffer of all the living entities. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's commentary, Prabhupada quotes in that particular verse, the difference between Jesus Christ and Vasudev Dat. Right? Jesus said that, you know, I take their sin upon myself. So Prabhupada writes in that purport, Jesus died, he took upon himself the sins of those who actually surrender to him. If you surrender to me, I will take your sinful reactions. If you don't, then I am not. And he took only the sins. So when you took the sin, the people have the dumping mentality. They come, whole week they perform, dump the sin and go away. Again to perform sin. They use it as a garbage can to dump in their sinful reactions of the week. It's not about a person or a religion. It's about the mentality. So, Vasudev Datta is saying, I want everyone to be liberated from the cycle of birth and death. Remove their ignorance and take them back. He's not asking about sinful. He's telling their whole material existence be finished. Mahapralaya, let them go back. And I will suffer for my... And it's not that somebody who knows, somebody who doesn't know, surrender to him, not surrender. He said, no, everyone in this universe, whom I know, whom I don't know. And then he says, it's not about just the sin. It's about their material existence. And this is just one. Therefore, Mahaprabhu, when he heard, he was glorifying as if he had 100 mouths. And he was so overwhelmed. You know, his body was shaking. Just to think of what kind of readiness, what kind of responsibility, what kind of burden a devotee is ready to take just to understand, relieve me of my anxiety. In fact, that is Vaishnavism. relieving Krishna's headache. Same spirit, Ramanujacharya. Ready to go to hell so that everyone can be liberated. Even though I may go to hell by giving the mantra which is not to be given. Patra, patra, na dekhe, na dekhe, sthan, asthan. So this is the spirit of Vaishnavism. So with such sons, surely the father is relieved of his burden, because children take that burden. That's truly Vedic culture, to take upon themselves the burden. And this whole philosophy of Vaishnavism teaches the art of shifting our life, transforming our life from being the burden to the culmination of relieving the burden of the Lord. It doesn't matter. I don't mind staying in this world. Mama janmani janmani ishware. It's not about deliverance, but I don't mind. As long as I am serving you. What a level. No wonder this philosophy is so difficult to practice, because it's not easy. And I'll just conclude with just one. What is the underlying principle that helps us make the transformation or helps us traverse this journey from being the burden to relieving the burden? This whole knowledge, creating a culture, Srila Prabhupada created the culture of knowledge. The knowledge of tattvatah, janma karma chame divyam evam yoveti tattvatah, tyaktva deham punarjanma naiti. So this knowledge, if we know tattvatah, knowing Krishna tattvatah, knowing jiva tattvatah, knowing his energy, shakti, tattvatah. Because when you know Krishna tattvatah, Vishnu tattva, when you know jiva tattvatah, that I am an insignificant, tiny part, and Krishna is the cause of all causes, the source of everything, he is sustaining everything, maintaining everything, everything is him. And his energy, which if forgotten can act as maya, mahamaya, and bind me, and if properly, you know, dealt with, it can turn into yogamaya. So if this understanding is there, born of that knowledge is humility. You cannot but be humbled. If we know tattvatah, Krishna tattvatah and jiva tattvatah and maya tattvatah, mama maya duratyaya, immediately a person actually becomes humble. The ego goes away. Balam balavatam chaham, buddhir buddhimatam asmi. What have I to be proud of? Borrowed plumes. And born of that humility is dependence. That's why Trinadapi Suni Chena Taro Rivasaishna. Dependence on so many things for our existence. And because of appreciating that, there is appreciation. Wow, had this not happened, where would I be? And born of that appreciation is a very, very deep sense of gratitude. And that gratitude is the underlying quality that helps us to transform this burden of the beast that we think right now to a burden of love. The burden will be there. The body is going to be there, the relations are going to be there, the world is going to be there, we are going to be there. The burden is going to be there. But this change of attitude to gratitude will change it from the burden of the beast to the burden of love. And out of that love, and when we try to become an instrument of that, without our knowledge, like Jaranivas Prabhu once said, you don't worry, you worry about Krishna's desire, Krishna will worry about your desire. You don't worry about yourself. You worry about Lord Chaitanya's mission. It is Lord Chaitanya's worry to think about you. And he is Achyuta, he never fails. Don't worry. That is his worry. Yoga kshemam vahamyaham. He is a responsibility. Ekhono tumara bhara. Bhakti no Thakur. Abhi wo sab karna tumara bhara hai bas. Main tumpe chhod diya. Tumara bhara, mera bhara. Aur mera bhara, tumara. Tum jo karna hai, karo. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Grantharaj Srimad Bhag. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu. It was a very, very nourishing and enlightening class. And at last, it was icing on top how you said, like, Krishna will, you have to just worry about Krishna and Acharya.
Understanding the mood of our Acharyas. So, number one, we make an effort to understand the mission. Number two, to imbibe it within ourselves. And as per our capacity and as per the wishes of our authorities and others, because ultimately we have to, it should be pleasing. We don't know Krishna is pleased or not. We are on that platform. So pleasing Guru, Vaishnavas. To that extent, we will try to be a part of the solution. Burden of the beast means being a part of the problem. And burden of love means being a part of the solution. Whatever that means, and whatever, as per time, place and circumstance, it is revealed to us. Or we understand. Try to do the needful. The biggest block, only block actually, is the false ego. And it manifests in so many ways as an obstacle to that becoming a transparent instrument of an Acharya's compassion. So I think our responsibility is to purify our existence and then allow the Lord will do the needful at the right time in a proper way. But we should be ready, receptive and eager to what role we can play, we don't know. We just try our best to kind of sit. No, no, that answers your question, but as I understood it.
Thank you, Prabhu. It was a wonderful answer. Because personally, I'm so inspired by your example. Like for years, you are amazingly absorbing the Krishna Goya and distributing and carrying out so many instructions of Maharaj and creating wonderful CDD and systems and there is a growth. So just seeing you, like, I used to see you so many years, like sitting and reading for hours, Prabhupada books are getting absorbed. So we are always inspired by you. Just ask.
Yeah, we have to do the needful to survive. Strategy for survival. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Shila Prabhupada ki jai. Granth Raj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai.